Have you ever wondered why the keys on your computer are all mixed up? I mean, look at these things. It's like someone just jumbled them all together. It's definitely not in alphabetical order. It's even like that on our devices without physical keyboards. Well, the reason for that is it's actually a solution to a problem from over 130 years ago. The now ubiquitous QWERTY layout actually started with this, the typewriter, one actually much older than the one you see here. Since many of you probably have never even seen a mechanical typewriter, let's look at its operation. Pressing a key moves a lever, which in turn raises a type bar. This is actually a fairly efficient and elegant mechanical system. It does, however, have one fatal flaw. When two close keys are struck in rapid succession, it makes it possible for the type bars to jam. As it turns out, in the English language, many common letter combinations are actually near each other alphabetically. Therefore, a straight alphabetical keyboard is much more likely to jam. A man by the name of Christopher Sholes decided to solve this issue by making what became the QWERTY keyboard, which moves common letter combinations apart. His design became the de facto standard after the success of the Remington 2 typewriter, which used it. Typewriter mechanics are also behind the diagonal layout of the keys themselves. This was to allow space for the levers. Of course, both of these designs continued to be in use, even on devices that have no moving parts. Also of note is that since QWERTY was designed for English, there are actually alternatives for other languages, such as AZERTY. There are even some popular English alternatives, such as Dvorak. Isn't it interesting that a solution to a mechanical problem that no longer exists continues to influence the design of our technology today? Well, that's all for this one, guys. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.